So the other night, some moron ran into my car. As a result, my seatbelt locked up. I can't safely strap myself into the car because it just won't retract. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to fix this problem. Let's start with two flathead screwdrivers. We're going to pop up the clips that hold down the side panel. So we can go ahead and pull it up. Same process up front, but hold your horses, because with the Phillip screwdriver, you're going to want to take off this cap and remove this one screw. With that off, you can now pull it out. Alright, hop on over to the back seat with me. We're going to take off this last panel, which will give us access to the seatbelt. There's going to be two bolts holding this in. On the bottom is a 14mm, up top is a 10mm. We're going to loosen these up, but before we take it off, we have to remove this clip on the bottom here. You can either pull it back with a flathead or your nail. Let's flip it to the right and take a closer look. You can see here there are small white pins that are holding this cover down. We're going to try and make with what we got. So I took my small Allen key and the end of my ratchet and just beat these little pins out. Alright, let's flip it onto the other side. Pay attention to this little white box here. It's got some clips on it that you can push with your flathead or just take it off with a pair of pliers. And off comes your cover. This shiny piece that I'm poking out with the flathead is what we want to get to. So I'm going to flick up this little salmon colored piece along with the seafoam green disc that's behind it in order to get to it. There is a small spring behind this plate, but it doesn't have much tension, so it's fairly easy to take off. Just be careful. You can see here that the seatbelt doesn't retract still. It's because the teeth have locked it into place. So with a little bit of pressure, your fingers turn the disc clockwise and it'll break it free. Here's a closer look of that shiny piece I was telling you that had the seatbelt locked into place. All right, it seems to be working fine. Let's put back on our seafoam plate with the spring. Then our salmon colored half plate on top of that. And finally, our white cover. Now for the white pins that went in, I found it fairly easy to put them back in with just a set of pliers. It crimped them in just fine. Then our 14mm socket. We ratchet on our bottom bolt, 10mm to ratchet up our top. Finally, we clipped on this sensor and all the paneling so we can test out our seatbelt. Ah! Darn it! Oh, that's right. This card is built in with a safety feature, so it locks up when you brake hard. And that's it, guys. If you enjoyed it, make sure to like this video and subscribe for more content. Here are a list of the tools that I used, so go ahead and get yours ready and get the job done. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Thanks, guys.